Hello and welcome. This video will give you tips on what to include in your portfolio, how to send your portfolio to us, and how to photograph your artwork if you decide to send it to us digitally. As soon as we receive your UCAS application, we'll email you asking you to send us a portfolio. You can send us your actual portfolio, you can bring it in person, but you might prefer to send it digitally. More on that later. First of all, here are a few tips on how to create a great portfolio. As well as your finished work, we'd like to see unfinished work and work at different stages of completion. We're interested in details of work, for example, close-ups of paintings. And we're interested in a range of work. We want pages from sketchbooks, and we want work that you've been making outside of your studies. So you might have been working on a music video, for example, or you might have been working with a theatre group making costumes or stage sets. You might be doing fashion, photography, or design in your foundation course. We want to see those. You might be doing a photography A-level as well as your fine art A-level. We want to see work from that, because we're interested in what motivates you. We're interested in how you move an idea through into the finished work. We're interested in your visual thinking. Now, if you do decide to send your portfolio digitally, you'll need to be photographing your artwork. Now, that can be a little tricky, but here's some tips to help you. First of all, if you can, use a real camera rather than your phone. Put the work in an uncluttered, clean space, for example, against a white wall rather than in the studio or surrounded by other work or in your front room. Light it as well as possible. That could include photographing it outdoors in sunlight or indoors with sunlight coming through a window. It may just be a case of positioning it to get the best use of indoor lighting. You need the lighting to be shining onto the artwork from the same direction you're positioned in when you're taking the photograph. If you're outdoors, get the sun behind you or just to one side to avoid a shadow. If you're using artificial light, try to get it coming from both sides to get an even light. So again, you're avoiding shadows. Remember, you can crop the image afterwards to avoid including lots of empty walls surrounding it. You can send us up to 50 slides as a PowerPoint or as a folder of images. Our advice is use as many of the slides as you can, so you can include then pages from sketchbooks, unfinished work and so on. You can send your digital portfolio on a memory stick, on a CD. You can send it via Google Docs or WeTransfer, etc. So here are the five main points to remember from this film. Show us the full range of your creative work, including work done outside of your studies. Include pages from sketchbooks, unfinished work, and details of work. If you're photographing your work, make sure the images are good quality and are in focus and well lit. Concentrate on the artwork itself and don't clutter your photos with other things. Include sound and video files and any web links if you need to. And finally, send us some basic information about what we're looking at. Is this a small painting? Is it a big painting? What's this sculpture made of? If you follow these tips, it'll help us to appreciate the range and the quality of your artwork. So for further information and advice, visit our website, get in touch with us directly. We're always happy to hear from you, and thank you for watching, and good luck with your application.